heat and temperature. So that first one is about heat. As we know that heat itself it is a form of energy.
It produces sensation in our body.
We can feel whether the body is hot or cold. So here, as we already know that heat always flows from hot body to cold body. That means the body of higher temperature to the body of lower temperature when the bodies are making contact, right? The here the heat flows from hot body to cold body till the two bodies temperature is same. When the two bodies temperature is same, right, two bodies having the same temperature, then the heat does not flow from one body to another body. And this process is nothing but thermal equilibrium. Then we can say that the bodies are in thermal equilibrium position. This is hot body and this is cold body. So once the bodies are in thermal equilibrium position, the hot body does not use the heat and the cold body does not receive the heat, because the two bodies temperature remains same and this position is nothing but thermal equilibrium position, right? So heat can be converted into other forms of energy. The heat energy is converted into other forms of energy, and other forms of energy are also converted into heat energy, right? So there are various forms of energies, right? Heat energy, like based upon this heat energy, sound energy, light energy, potential energy, kinetic energy. So there is so many energies are there. Coming to the units, SI unit for this heat is joule. CS unit is calorie. Joule is the SI unit, and not serious, you use another unit, other commonly used unit, calorie, right? So one calorie is equal to 4.2 joules. One calorie is equal to 4.2 joules, and 1 kilocalorie is equal to 1000 joules. Sorry, 1000 calories. One calorie is equal to 4.2 joules. 1 kilocalorie is equal to 1000 joules, and 1 kilojoules. Celebrating. 1 kilojoule is equal to 1000 joules, and 1 joule is equal to 10^7 atoms in CDS system. 1 joule is equal to 10^7. Yes. The quantity of heat energy is required to raise the temperature of 1 gram of water through 1 degree Celsius, and it is nothing but 1 calorie. 1 calorie is nothing but the amount, it is the unit of heat. So the amount of heat energy required to raise the temperature of 1 gram of water through 1 degree Celsius, and the amount of heat energy required is 1 calorie, right? Temperature, it is nothing but the degree of hotness or coldness of your body. The degree of hotness or coldness of your body, right? When an object is heated, the temperature in that body rises up. When it is cooled, the temperature decreases. Therefore, heat is the cause of temperature. Cause of temperature. Right. So coming to the units, SI unit for temperature is Kelvin. We have other units to measure the temperature. Other units for temperature are degrees Celsius and degrees Fahrenheit. Right. Both heat and temperature are scalar quantities. Both are scalar quantities because these does not depend upon it direction. It has only magnitude. Once if we discuss about the differences between heat and temperature, heat is a form of energy. It causes the sensation of and it causes the sensation to the body. Whereas temperature is the degree of hotness or coldness of a body. SI unit for heat is joule. Other units is calorie. SI unit is Kelvin. Other units are degree Celsius, degree Fahrenheit. Heat is the effect. Due to this effect, the temperature will. Heat is the cause, and temperature is the effect. The heating effect is temperature, right? Heat is measured by using calorimeter, whereas temperature is measured by using thermometer, right? Like this, we can see the differences between heat and temperature. Next one is about calorimetry. So it is a branch of physics which deals with the study of measurement of heat. It is a branch of physics. It studies about the measurement of heat, right? So there is a principle for this calorimetry. The principle of this calorimetry is if two bodies at different temperatures are in thermal contact and no heat is allowed to go out or enter into, there are two bodies. These two bodies are at different temperatures, right? So, and these two bodies are in thermal contact like this. These two bodies make in contact, body A and body B. And if no heat is allowed to the surroundings, the heat, it is hot body. Let's say the temperatures are 90 degrees Celsius and 35 degrees Celsius, right? So in this concept, if no heat is allowed, the body heat is completely transferred to body B only, and the body A's temperature does not transfer to the surroundings, to the atmosphere, does not transfer to the atmosphere, and atmosphere temperature is not received by these bodies. These bodies' temperature does not sense to the atmosphere, and atmosphere temperature does not receive by these bodies, right? Is it clear? And as that, there is no chemical reaction taking place between these two bodies. Only heat energy is transferring. Only heat and energy is transferring. In this case, the heat energy gained by hot body, sorry, gained by cold body is equal to heat energy lost by hot body. Right? So if there is no temperature receiving, that means there is no heat energy transferring from our atmosphere to these bodies or from these bodies to atmosphere, and there is also no chemical reaction takes place between these two bodies, only heat energy is transferring, right? So in this case, then the heat energy gained by the cold body is equal to the heat energy lost by the hot body, right? So in this case, when a certain amount of heat is supplied to the body, right? So here B is the cold body when compared to the body A. The amount of heat energy supplied to the body B, right? So that heat energy is denoted by Q. So that heat energy is depends upon the mass of the body, and heat energy is depend upon the change in temperature. Right? From these two, I'm writing that the heat energy depends upon that directly proportional to the mass. The heat energy is directly proportional to the rising temperature, that means change in temperature. So that heat energy is directly proportional to the mass, and heat energy is directly proportional to the rising temperature. So this is nothing but, so that the amount of heat energy absorbed by the body, that amount of heat energy absorbed by the body depends upon the mass of the body, and that amount of heat energy absorbed by the body depends upon the rising temperature. So from these two, I am writing that Q is directly proportional to M into delta T. Here, it is directly proportional, Q is directly proportional to mass into change in temperature. So here I am replacing this directly proportionality with a constant and making an equation. Q is equal to S into M into delta T. Right? Where S is nothing but specific heat, or we can say that it has a proportionality constant or specific heat of a body. Specific heat of a body. So that from this, S is nothing but specific heat. Specific heat varies from body to body, right? So specific heat, it depends upon nature of material. Mainly specific heat depends upon the nature of material. Now specific heat can be defined as amount of heat required to raise the temperature of unit mass of a substance through 1 degree Celsius or 1 degree Kelvin. So that specific heat is denoted by S. So from this equation, the heat energy required is equal to specific heat capacity of a body into mass of the body into change in temperature. So here S is nothing but specific heat, or sometimes we call it specific heat capacity, both are same. Specific heat or specific heat capacity. Clear? So from this, the specific heat can be defined as the amount of heat energy required to raise the temperature of unit mass of a substance through 1 degree Celsius or 1 degree Kelvin. So from this equation, I am writing this specific heat capacity is equal to Q by M into delta T. where U is the heat energy, so the units for heat energy is joule or calories. Where here from this equation I am writing S, S is equal to, we need only S, so M and density are in product. So if we send this to towards Q, that will become division with Q, so Q by M into density. So from this formula I am defining this definition for specific heat. The amount of heat energy required to raise the temperature of unit mass, here mass is 1 unit of a substance, through change in temperature is either 1 degree Celsius or 1 degree Kelvin, right? So S is equal to Q by M into delta T, where Q is heat energy, M is mass, and delta T is change in temperature. So writing the units, SI units for Q, heat is joule, mass is kg, temperature is Kelvin, joule by kg into Kelvin, C or CGS, calories by gram into degrees Celsius. That's it. Heat capacity. This heat capacity is also known as thermal capacity. Denoted by H, heat capacity or thermal capacity. In the previous case we saw that specific heat capacity is denoted by S, but here in this case the heat capacity is denoted by H, right? So here heat capacity can be defined as the main difference between specific heat capacity and heat capacity is, in specific heat capacity we consider as unit mass, but here in this heat capacity we consider as the given mass, the given body, right? So heat capacity can be defined as the amount of heat energy required to raise the body's temperature through 1 degree Celsius or 1 degree Kelvin. The amount of heat energy required to raise the body's temperature through 1 degree Celsius or 1 degree Kelvin, right? So from this heat capacity, H is equal to E heat energy formula, Q by raising temperature, that's it. Whereas specific heat capacity, S is equal to Q by M into delta T. If you consider this both, H is equal to Q by delta T, where S is equal to Q by M into delta T. Here there is no mass, here there is a mass, that is the main difference. Here mass is nothing but unit mass, here the body's temperature, the whole body will change, the whole body's temperature will change, but here the unit mass of the body temperature will change, that is the main difference, right? So here H is equal to Q by delta T. Coming to the units, SI unit for heat capacity is joule by Kelvin, whereas CGS unit is calorie by degree Celsius. Coming to the units of this specific heat capacity, SI unit is joule by kg into Kelvin, CGS units are calorie by gram into degree Celsius. You can observe this. Here there is no mass, here there is a mass. That is the main difference. Is it clear? Right? So, and there is a difference between, so there is a relation between these two, H and S. Right? So, S is equal to Q by M into delta T. Here I am writing as 1 by M into Q by delta T. Right? So that is equal to Q by delta T is nothing but H. So H by 1 by M into H. Right? It is nothing but S. S is equal to 1. That implies S is equal to H by M. We need heat capacity. H is equal to MS. So it is the relation between heat capacity and specific heat capacity. Right? We will continue this in the next class. In the next class, we are going to learn about change of state and latent heat. Clear? Thank you.